working now for 11 years in the area of IT security. And concerning this specific research about Microsoft Windows Faith Authentication, we started back in October of last year. And I think we had the first results within 4 days until we managed to have the first spoofing attack against the default setup without the enhanced anti-spoofing feature, enhanced security. The technology was around since 2015, so yeah, 2 years, and nobody had a closer look, obviously, or nobody publicly made any information available of about how to spoof it. Yeah, so we were the first to publicly disclose that there is an issue with specific versions of Windows 10 and the combination of soft and hardware device that is used for this kind of authentication. There's the possibility of actually performing a spoofing attack for authentication bypass, and that's a property you don't want to have in an authentication system. And it was also possible by rather simple means, because a 2D paper printout on a laser printer was enough to do it. So you have to take a picture with a specific camera, but the specific camera only is near infrared, and you can buy them on Amazon, as I did, for a couple of euros, for example. And yeah, print out the picture, and then you can have access in an unauthorized way to a Windows 10 device that you're targeting. It's just a creative process. We did some trial and error with different materials, stuff like that, and yeah, suddenly we succeeded. And it was only a black box test, so we didn't do any deeper analysis of how it actually works, but it was enough to think about how it could work and then try some things out. Good thing about biometrics is it is really convenient for end users, and it's user-friendly, but it's not that secure. Yeah. When using biometric authentication, it should only be one of more factors. So in a two-factor authentication process, for example, it's okay. So you have the biometric face authentication as step one, and then you also have to enter your password, for example, or your PIN. So that's okay, but to solely rely on the biometric isn't a good idea. And also regarding other biometric systems that were defeated in the past. So there were fingerprint scanners that were defeated in the past, there were iris scanners that were defeated in the past, and there were different face authentication systems that were defeated in the past. Yeah. But there are also biometric systems that are more secure than others. For example, when comparing the Windows Hello face authentication, at least in the older versions that are vulnerable, to Face ID by Apple that is used on iPhone X, these are two different worlds. So it is much harder to perform a spoofing attack against the iPhone X with Apple Face ID than it is to perform against Windows with an older version. So in the case of Microsoft, you only use 2D information, two-dimensional data. And when talking about the Apple Face ID, you have three-dimensional data. So when spoofing a face, you have to have a three-dimensional representation. This was the first customer that asked questions about the security of Windows 10 face authentication, and Windows 10 was released 2 years ago. So I don't think that it's that widely used, but it's widely spread, because any Windows 10 installation has this feature available. Windows 10 face authentication system, it's only used instead of a password, for example, or a smart card. Yeah, as an authentication factor to the operating system to gain access to your desktop. And Microsoft has already improved its product in newer versions. So newer versions are not affected anymore by this simple spoofing attack using one paper printout showing a specially processed image. The anti-spoofing feature not only uses the infrared information by the infrared camera, but also the information by the RGB camera. And so they combine different data sources and have other algorithms that combine the stuff. I just researched some face recognition methods and algorithms and which features are actually important for the algorithms to work properly. So you have to have a good contrast of your features, of course, so that they can be automatically detected and that the algorithms work. And the brightness also has to be correct. Well, there was the Samsung iris scan, for example, that was also hacked 1.5 years ago, I think, by Starbucks. So they tried to use a new kind of authentication system that failed, obviously. Then, of course, there are different types of fingerprinting scanners also in Windows 10 that could also be bypassed. So spoofing is the way to go. to bypass it. So you have to get access one time to the biometric features, for example, the fingerprints or taking a picture using an RGB camera, near-infrared camera, and that's it. It's hard to change your face, it's hard to change your fingerprints. Yeah, that's an obvious disadvantage, actually, of biometric systems, yeah. You cannot simply say, oh, all your fingerprints were stolen, and please reset your fingerprints. It's not that easy, yeah, and not possible. So in my experience over the last 11 years now in this business, I think things have changed for the better. And yeah, now the developers and manufacturers are listening to researchers who say, hey, I found a security issue here, and I also may have a solution. You could try this or that.